Good afternoon, my dear sisters and brothers. We have listened to another version of the Beatitudes coming from the Gospel of Luke. The other one can be found in the Gospel of Matthew. And there is quite a difference between the two. For example, in Matthew, it says, "Blessed are you who are poor in spirit," spiritually poor. But here, Luke, the Gospel for the poor, said, "Blessed are you who are poor." Pinagpala kayong mga dukha, literal na dukha, walang mga makaing dukha, walang mga sariling tahanang dukha, mga namamalimos sa kalsadang dukha, pinagpala kayo mga dukha. At first, it may be very difficult to understand, and it is also open to misunderstanding. Isn't it that Jesus fed the poor? He performed miracles, multiplication of the loaves, for example, to feed the poor? Isn't it that Jesus, when he came, performed miracles for the poor, healing the sick, curing their illnesses, freeing them from possessions of evil? Now, here Jesus is saying, "Blessed are you who are poor." Is it not that Jesus is kind of exalting their poverty? Mapalad kayo, pinagpala kayo, dahil mahirap kayo. Eh kung mahirap sila at pinagpala sila, bakit niya pinapakain ang mga mahihirap? Bakit niya iniibsan ang paghihirap ng mga mahihirap? Hindi ba dapat ay sabihin ni Jesus, "Tiisin niyo yan, mahirap kayo, tiisin niyo yan, anyway, pinagpala kayo." Is that it? Yun ba? Palagay ko po, hindi. Anong ibig sabihin itong ebanghelyong ito? "Blessed are you who are poor." Well, you have to take that into consideration when we know that Jesus came to proclaim the kingdom of heaven. The many parables that we hear, they speak of the kingdom of heaven. The kingdom of heaven is like this. The kingdom of heaven is like that. Now, what does it mean, the kingdom of heaven has arrived? It means that God will do something in order to alleviate poverty. God, by establishing His kingdom, will change the status or situation of those who are poor, who are weeping, who are hungry, who are lonely. I'll give you an example based on what was written by Segundo Galilea, a liberation theologian. He said, in a poor community in Andes, the place has been forgotten that in this place where there are many poor people, there was no clinic, there was no health care, there was no doctor, there was no nurse. That is why when people in that village get sick, they have nowhere to go, and most of them die prematurely. Mahirap sila. Walang clinic sa barangay, walang gamot sa barangay, at lalong walang doktor sa barangay. But in that place also, there are some people who are better off, living a more comfortable life. Pag nagkakasakit sila, they have the money to go to the city, no, to the hospital in the city, para dun magpagaling. That is the situation in that community. And then, one day, there was an announcement. A clinic will be built in that place. The government will put up a clinic for that community. There will be medicines in that clinic. There will be a doctor coming there regularly, and a nurse will stay there. Now, tell me, between the poor and the more comfortable people in that same community, who will be more happy? Eh di yung mga poor. Kasi finally, magkakaroon na ng clinic. They will be more happy because there will be medicines already. Of course, the clinic is not only for the poor. Even those who are better off can go to the clinic. But more poor people or poor people will be more beneficiaries of the clinic. Kasi dumating na yung clinic. Sabi nga ni Segundo Galilea, during the blessing, the priest came, he blessed the clinic, and then he said, well, now happy are the poor, there is now a clinic. Now, Jesus is telling that, happy are the poor because the clinic of the soul, the kingdom of heaven, is here already. Now, is the kingdom of heaven only for the poor? No. It is for everyone, poor and rich alike. But the poor will benefit more from the kingdom of heaven because they have been deprived for so long. Are we poor that we have been deprived for so long? That is the meaning of the gospel. Happy are the poor because the kingdom of God has been inaugurated by His coming. Now, what is the challenge to us? The challenge to us is to do our very best to hasten the realization of the kingdom. Sa Ama namin, dinadasal namin, no, mapasa amin ang kaharian mo. Pero mas maganda sa Ingles, thy kingdom come. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. You and I, we have the mission. And our mission is to speed up the realization of the kingdom of heaven here on earth. Sa atin, mga pagbibigay, sa ating pagbabahagi, unti-unti nating mabubuo at mapabibilis ang pagbuo ng kaharian ng Diyos. Of course, the Lord will work, but it will be better if we will also work with the Lord so that the poor will be happy. Yun ang challenge sa atin ng mga nasa kaharian ng Diyos. Pabilisin natin ang katuparan ng kaharian ng Diyos. Nang sa ganun, dumating na ang araw na wala nang mahirap, wala nang magugutom, wala nang mauuhaw, wala nang malulungkot, sapagkat ang kaharian ng Diyos ay narito na. You and I, that is our mission, to hasten the realization of God's kingdom. Amen.
Please stand.